Today marks exactly 3 months until Californians will vote in the presidential primary, March 3rd. Come this Monday, nonpartisan mail-in voters will have to pick a party in order to receive a presidential primary ballot. News 8's Heather Hope is live at the Registrar of Voters tonight with all the ways to make this selection in time. Heather?
Right, Barbara Lee, if you're a nonpartisan and mail-in ballot voter like myself, maybe you misplaced this card or forgot to make your party selection altogether. Either way, there's just a little bit of time, and I'll show you the different ways that you can get this process done.
Time is of the essence now. We are 60 days away from the presidential primary election.
In just 3 months, Californians will vote in the primaries.
You need to update your information? Do so now. Do not delay.
Of 1.8 million registered voters in San Diego County, notices were sent to 380,000 nonpartisan mail ballot voters to select a political party for the primary. But so far, only 49,000 people have mailed back their selections.
What that means is that there are tens of thousands of individuals that have not responded back to this card, and we need them to respond back by January 6th.
By Monday, voter registrar Michael Vu says his office needs to know what type of ballot to send mail-in voters. I received the nonpartisan notice, but never responded until now.
So you have a few options to get this done. You can mail it back, you can call it in, you can even do it online or show up to the voter registrars, fill out the form, and simply turn it in. Thank you, Christine.
Perfect, thank you.
It's also simple online. You select the nonpartisan voter ballot options from sdvote.com to pick a political party there by deciding and easily emailing back the form.
You've got three political parties that have opened it up. To nonpartisan voters, that's the Democratic Party, the Libertarian Party, as well as the American Independent Party. And then you have three political parties that have closed up their presidential candidates to only those that are registered with their respective political party. That's the Republican Party, the Green Party, as well as the Peace and Freedom Party.
Of course, you can show up to vote in person on election day to make your party selection then. And due to a new law, you can also register to vote on the day of the election at your polling place.
If you make one of those selections of those party ballots, it does not change your party. You still get to keep your nonpartisan status.
So all is not lost if you don't get this party selection ballot completed and mailed in time, but you can risk getting your mail-in ballot delayed to you. As this primary comes up, a high voter turnout is expected. Barbara Lee and Carlo.
All right, Heather, thanks.